Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Allahumma salli ala Muhammad wa Ali Muhammad. According to one view, on this day, in the year 95 after Hijrah, the famous Tabi'i, Zaid ibn Jubayr, passed away. Before I get into speaking about this famous Tabi'i, I'd like to mention one of the big problems that we have in our Muslim world today is that ongoing accusation against the followers of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, that they have no respect for the Sahaba, that they curse all of the companions and the Tabi'een and anyone that surrounded Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi. This has been fed into the minds of so many Sunni Muslims that it's very, very difficult for us to counter-argue it or convince someone that that's not the case. Yes, we have our own kind of understanding that there are some who are good, there are also some who are bad. Now, we can meet halfway and we can discuss each and every one of them as far as their characteristics and their personalities are concerned, but whatever the case may be, it still does not lead or should not lead to that takfiri mentality, which unfortunately some people have come across these kind of very famous fatwas coming from the Salafis who say that because you disrespect the Sahaba and the Tabi'een, you are entitled to be killed, unfortunately. Now, this famous Tabi'i was an exceptional scholar, a pious, righteous person, an admirer of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, so much so that he was among the elite companions of Imam Ali as-Sajjad salamullahi alayhi. He also participated in a revolt against Bani Umayyah, and that's why Al-Hajjaj ibn Yusuf al-Thaqafi ordered that he be killed, and he was martyred, unfortunately. I think it's interesting if my brothers and sisters read into the biography of this famous person, especially how he fled to Isfahan and then to Qom, and the whole story surrounding his martyrdom. He's buried in Al-Wasat in Iraq, and many people visit him until today. Walhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen.
من يلهيه المرديان المال والأمل